Hello, welcome again. We are solving ITJ physics. The topic is current electricity and circuit analysis. Question number 81 is, in the electric network shown, no current flows through 4 ohm resistor in the arm EB. The potential difference between A and D will be option 1 6 volt, option 2 3 volt, option 3 5 volt and option 4 4 volt. So let the potential difference, potential at D point is 0, okay, and then the potential at E point will also be 0, okay, and as no current flow through this, so the potential at D will be only due to this 4, so and it is positive and negative, it will be minus 4V, okay, and the potential at A will be minus 4V plus 9, or that is 5, so VA will be 5 and VD is 0, so VA minus VD is 5. Okay. Answer is option 3. Okay. Next, a 10 volt battery with internal resistance 1 ohm and a 15 volt battery with internal resistance 0.6 ohm are connected in parallel to a voltmeter. The reading of the voltmeter will be close to. So, as these are connected, the options are 11.9 volt to 13.1 volt. 3, 12.5 volt, 4, 24.5 volt. As they are connected in parallel, so the the voltmeter reading will be same for both. Okay, suppose I1 is the current flowing through this and I2 is the current flowing through this. But net current flowing is your 0. Okay, because voltmeter will not consume any current because we are assuming it to be I0. So I is equal to I1 plus I2. Okay, so totally I is 0, so I2 will be equal to minus I1. This is your positive. Okay. Now applying capacitor class on A, B, C, D. So it will be minus I2 into 0.6. Okay. And plus 15, and then it will be minus 10 and plus I1 into 1. Okay. So minus I2 into 0.6, and this is 5 and this is I1. So minus and I2 is equal to minus I1. Okay. So it will be I1 into 0.6 plus 5 plus I1, or 1.6 I1 is equal to minus 5, or I1 is equal to minus 5 by 1.6 is equal to 3.125. So the potential drop is potential drop because I1 is minus 3.25, so 3.25 into 1 minus plus 10 because this is going to be negative. Okay, so I1 value is minus, so it is 3.125 plus 10 or 13.125 volt. Option 2 is the next. Suppose drift velocity Vd in a material varied with electric field E, as Vd is equal to root E. The VI graph of the wire made of such a material is best given by, so I is your NEAVD. So N is number of electrons per unit volume and E is charge, A is your area of Vd, drift velocity, and Vd is given as that equal to root E. Keeping all other things constant, I will be equal to root E. Okay. And this VD is drift velocity and potential is given by this V into V potential is given by E into L. V E is electrical field and L is distance travel. So V is equal to E. So we can say that current is equal to voltage root, so option 2 is the that graph seems to be right. Okay, so answer is option 2. Next, in a large building there are 15 bulbs of 40 watt, 5 bulbs of 100 watt, 5 fans of 80 watt, and a heater of 1 watt, 1 kilowatt. The voltage electric mains is 220 volt. The minimum capacity of the main fuse of the building will be. So total power is your 15 bulbs of 40 watt. So 15 into 40, and 5 bulbs of 100 watt, 5 into 100, and 5 fans of 80 watt, 5 into 80, and 1 heater of 1000 watt. So total wattage is 2500, and current as a voltage source is 220 volt. Okay, so the current will be your 11.3. So the minimum capacity of fuse should be at, should be more than this, that is 12 ampere. So answer is option C.